justice for all. Madam Clerk, if we could have a roll call, please.
Councilman Knox.
Present.
Councilman Otesha.
Present.
Councilman Shoemaker.
Here.
Councilwoman McCartney.
Here.
Councilwoman Hall.
Here.
Mayor Pro Temp Hagerty.
Here.
Mayor Taylor.
Here.
All members are present this evening, Mayor.
Before we start our meeting tonight, pursuant to our city charter, council members Catherine Hall, Carmel Knox, and Colleen McCartney continue to serve as council members of this board until the successors are qualified following the election certification by the county of elected city officials and their results. So we need a motion from the board to accept Councilwoman Hall, Knox, McCartney to be able to vote pursuant to our city charter.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Hagerty, supported by Councilman Otesha. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you. Next item on our agenda is going to be our consent agenda. Are there any items on the consent agenda council wishes to have removed for discussion? If not, I'll need a motion from the board.
So moved.
I have a motion by Councilman Otesha, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Hagerty. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anyone against? Consent agenda has been approved. Next item on the agenda is approval for requests for an abatement. Mr. Monroe, we have none tonight. Is that correct?
That is correct, Mayor.
Okay, then we're going to move into our presentations tonight. And we are honored here to have Senator Veronica Kleinfeld, and she's going to give us our legislative update. And before we start, I want to congratulate not only you, but your family and the election for your son, Michael, who's now the new mayor of East Point.
Thank you. I appreciate it. And I don't have handouts or any fancy presentations to give. If you decide you would like to see what has passed the Senate, hasn't passed the House, vice versa, and what's made it all the way to the governor's office, we can create something to give to you at a later date. I just have a few notes I've written down. Perfect. On a tablet. Obviously, we spent this year codifying Props 1, 2, and 3. Prop 1 was the one that gave more financial disclosure for elected officials at the state level. I'd like to see it go further than it did, but you will be able to gain access to any investments I have, all my bank account numbers, the debt that I have, as well as every other member of the legislature and the executive, the Secretary of State, and the Attorney General's office. I wanted to first touch on a few things we were able to do for the city of Roseville. All of you probably know about the $100,000 that we were able to secure for the Optimist Club to do some things to help the youth, both in Fraser and Roseville was our hope with that money. What you may not know, because it was outside of my district, is the $5 million for the Martin Drain repair would have fallen on the Roseville residents. Because it wasn't in my district, I had to rely on Senator Hertel to make the ask and lobby for it for me. I'm very grateful to him for doing that, because we were able to get that into the budget, and that is money that the residents of Roseville will not have to pay. We also were able to secure $40 million for Macomb County Jail. We used up a significant amount of our capital together in order to get that. And that will revamp the intake so that we're properly assessing people for mental health issues and substance use disorders before going into the jail, so that we can set them up for help if they need it. And I think that's sorely needed nationwide. We just finished up the energy package. That was very contentious. It's a very big package with a lot of changes, but step by step, up until 2035, I believe it is, we're working to become a carbon-free state. We will be doing it in increments. The energy companies will have to be meeting as we go along. But I wanted to focus on what we've done for the residents. most at the local level. So first, with regard to school districts, we have put in free lunch for all students, which we think is, I remember paying for my kids' lunch and making ends meet, but that was really a bit of a struggle. So that's going to help a lot of folks. Some of these are just in this year's budget with the intent of getting them put in permanently. We raised the eligibility to cover the cost of pre-K up to 300% of the poverty limit, and we hope to eventually have pre-K available for everybody at no cost and have it be part of the curriculum, just as kindergarten and first through 12th grade are, because we all know now that that is really when the children are soaking in the information and doing most of their learning. So that is ultimately our goal. We have to figure out how to finance all of that, but I think it would make a big difference in how we rank among the other states if we can accomplish that. We also increased the per pupil spending from $91.50 to $96.08, and we are 100% funding special ed, which is a huge win for all school districts. Every school district in the state is going to save money, and this is millions of dollars statewide that the that will benefit that they can pour into other programming. We recognize the shortage of teachers. We have created incentives that if you graduate from school here and you want to teach here, we're going to help you pay for that college loan, $250 a month, if you stay here and work in our public school systems. We've put more money into community mental health for schools, recognizing that security alone is not going to fix all the problems that we have. We need to identify students that are having problems and get them some help. You also probably know about removing the retiree tax that was put in place a few years ago. Public employees are exempt, and we have restored the deductions for private employees. 500,000 individuals will see $1,000 more in their pocket this next year because of that. The earned income tax credit, we expanded to 30% of the federal level. In my district alone, 21,288 individuals will see $615 more dollars in their pocket this next year than they did in previous years. With regard to veterans, we have initiated MINGSTAP, which allows their children or their spouse to use their tuition money that they have earned, as opposed to them using it themselves. It doesn't cost the state any more money because we're not allocating any more per each veteran. We're just giving them the flexibility on how they would like to use it. We are exempting them from jury duty if they are deployed, obviously, in other places. And we are allowing them to have their bank accounts sit dormant for longer periods of time before those funds are seized because of multiple deployments. Just a few more things. We've ended child marriage in Michigan. Who would have thought that if your parent signs on, that at any age you could be married? And we did hear a lot of testimony of girls that were married against their will. So we took it straight to 18. There was a lot of debate on the floor over that, but in my opinion, if you're in love at 16, you'll still be in love at 18. So I was one of the sponsors of that bill. One of those bills was my package, and I'm very proud of that. You all know about the distracted driving, and now upcoming Death with Dignity. Three of us have introduced a package for individuals that are in the last 6 months of their lives. It has to be verified by two physicians. They have to be of sound mind and body to determine how and when the end of their life will come. And there has to be witnesses. There will be licensing for the doctors who choose to do that. So we've put in all kinds of safeguards. And then finally, gun safety. We've passed and is now in law extra penalties for individuals who do not store guns safely in homes where there are small children. Particularly, their penalties are severe if the child gets a hold of the weapon. And domestic abusers will no longer be able to carry guns as well. So that's just a snapshot of what we've done this year. There's a lot more, but I've already gone past the allotted time. So if there are any questions.
Questions from the board.
Thank you.
Sounds like you've been pretty darn busy.
Pretty busy. Oh, the last one I wanted to tell you is the trust fund for cities. It's really important. We worked on it for 8 months so that when there's a crash, the state can't balance its budget on our backs like they did the last time. It made it through the House. We were not able to get it through the Senate, but it's one of my number one missions is to get that trust fund so that cities have the safety that they deserve and don't get a higher brunt of the financial stress than the state does.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, thank you. Senator Kleinfeld, we appreciate your update, and thank you for all the hard work you're doing for us.
Thank you.
Next item on the agenda is hearing of the public, and this is going to be on agenda items only. Hearing of the public is designated. Please state your name and address and address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions, input information, or express opinions to the board. Anyone using inappropriate language will be called out of order. We'll correct your language or leave. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules will be called out of order by the chair. Anyone from the public wish to be heard on agenda items only at the first hearing of the public. Yes, sir.
Good evening, Mayor, Council. Rob DeBruin, 29411 Callahan, Roseville. I wanted to speak just briefly on the supervisor's contract. What's before you today is a ratification. It was a difficult process. I've been involved. This is my seventh contract I've been involved with. Although I was not on the negotiating team this time, I was involved in some capacity. And out of the seven contracts I've been involved with and in the six city managers, this is probably the second toughest one that I've seen just by virtue of some of the things that needed to be changed within it. It was a good process, mostly because Mr. Monroe and of course the godfather himself, Mr. Sexton, their leadership in this and their direction in this, there were some tough things that had to get done, and we had to understand them properly, and I believe our group understands them properly just, you know, because of the way we voted. And it is a good package that I don't think anybody is excited about, which kind of is what makes it a good package. So just when you go in there and you get it presented to you, there is at the end of a negotiation, it's always difficult because you're opposed to one another. There was no hard feelings. There was no, they're coming after this or doing this. Everything is still sailing along smoothly with the supervisors. I'll also be here for when you get to D, if you have any questions about the bidding of Memorial Park. All right, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else in the public wish to be heard on agenda items only at the first hearing of the public? If not, we're gonna move into the next item on agenda, which is unfinished business. Mr. Monroe?
We have none, sir.
Okay, that's a good thing. Then we're gonna move right into new business. First item in our new business is request adoption resolution awarding bid of sales to city-owned property, 25346 Pearl. Second reading. Mr. Gromyki, is that yours?
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and Council. This is the second reading of the full sale of all those parcels, A and B. I'll talk about combined. We rolled out, and the seller who was on the main package parcels was amenable to peel off that one parcel, and in turn, the city took one that was not buildable, and we'll keep that hopefully for a pocket park or other use. So happy to answer any questions, but we're getting rid of some properties that we got at a discount from the county on tax foreclosure that are vacant and hopefully buildable and can be put back on the tax rolls.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker?
I have one question for you, Jim.
Yes.
Where's the parcel that was not buildable?
Eastland. Eastland and Beaconsfield on the corner.
Okay.
Along 94.
I used to play football there when I was a kid.
No. Oh. Yeah. Now you still can.
I still might be able to do it again. Thank you.
Yep.
Mr. Thomas, will we open this up to the public, this one, and close it, or we don't need to? Okay, it's not a public hearing. Okay. Well, then I'll need a motion from the board on this agenda item.
So move.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Watisha, supported by Councilwoman Hall, to adopt the resolution awarding a bid of sale of city-owned property at 25346 Pearl, second reading. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. I don't think you're going to go anywhere yet.
Nope, that's fine.
Request adoption resolution awarding bid of sale for city-owned properties, multiple parcels. I know you got a whole bunch of them there, and I got them here somewhere, but is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, we're just grateful that we were able to secure somebody to do a package deal. So we'll have one bidder or one builder throughout the city doing multiple parcels. I believe there's 8 total that they'll be purchasing. And so it'll be, you know, consistent homes, consistent permitting. Everything will be nice and easy.
And just for the public, one person bought all these properties, correct?
Correct, except for A, letter A.
Yep.
Correct.
And the residents on both sides were allowed to purchase the property if they were interested. Is that correct?
It was all mailed certified, return receipt.
And that
those that wanted to purchase properties, those are done with and have long been done with, and we pursued the others through the bid process.
Okay. Questions from Mr. Gromyki on this agenda item? If not, I'll need a motion.
So moved.
Support.
I have a motion by Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty, supported by Councilman Watisha, to adopt the resolution awarding a bid for sale of city-owned properties, multiple parcels, second reading. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Item C, next is request Macomb Intermediate School District to collect 100% of their 2024 tax levy on a summer tax bill. Mr. Monroe.
Yes, Mayor. This is an annual request from Macomb Intermediate School District to move the payment from our winter taxes to the summer taxes. Historically, our council has denied this request. Mr. Churkin is asking that once again our council denies this request and we remain status quo.
Questions for Mr. Monroe? If not, what are the wishes of the board?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to deny from the Macomb Intermediate School District to collect 100% of their 2004 tax levy on the summer tax bill.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hall, supported by Councilwoman McCartney, to deny the request for the Macomb Intermediate School District to collect 100% of their 2024 tax levy on the summer tax bill as presented. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. Next item, item D, is request awarding a bid for the Veterans Memorial Park and Rotary Park renovations to Wing Construction AEW project number 0100-0514. Mr. Monroe.
Yes, Council. Council's been made aware of this project over the last several months. It's new roofs, updating, making the bathrooms and other facilities at both parks handicap and ADA compliant. The thought is to get this done so construction can begin over the wintertime on the roof and the interior of the building so that the facilities will be back up and running for springtime when the parks are generally more used by our residents. And Mr. Bruins to be here to answer any questions further that you might have.
Maybe Mr. Monroe can answer. Are we renovating the bathrooms at Rotary Park?
Yes, the complete, that's a more extensive renovation. The exterior, the roof, the bathrooms, everything needs to be done. That's an old building. As Rob will tell you, the brick is literally crumbling off the side of the building and it's way overdue for a major facelift.
Yeah, I've seen them not too long ago. It's a major renovation, but it's good. Thank you.
Any other questions from the board? If not, I'll need a motion.
So moved. Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Haas, supported by Councilwoman McCartney, to approve the awarding of the bid for the Veterans Memorial Park and Rotary Park renovations to Wing Construction, AEW project number 0100-0514. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Anyone against? Motion carries. Next item is request closed door session to discuss update council on Blunt versus City of Roseville, ED Michigan case number 23-11459 pursuant to MCL 15.269E. Madam Clerk, I'll need a roll call, please. I'll make a motion first. Yep.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman McCartney, supported by Councilwoman Hall. Mm-hmm. Madam Clerk, if we get a roll call, please.
Councilman Knox.
Yes.
Councilman Wetisha.
Yes.
Councilman Shoemaker.
Yes.
Councilwoman McCartney.
Yes.
Councilwoman Hall.
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty.
Yes.
Mayor Taylor.
Yes.
7 positive votes. Motion carried, Mayor.
Thank you. Next item on the agenda is request closed door session to discuss union negotiations pursuant to MCL 15.2681C. I'll need a motion.
So moved. Support.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Hager, supported by Councilwoman McCartney. Madam Clerk, if we could have a roll call, please.
Councilman Knox.
Yes.
Councilman Wetisha.
Yes.
Councilman Shoemaker.
Yes.
Councilwoman McCartney.
Yes.
Councilwoman Hall.
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty.
Yes.
Mayor Taylor.
Yes.
7 positive votes. Motion carried, Mayor.
Thank you. Next item G, is request closed door session to discuss legal proposal exempt from disclosure under attorney-client privilege pursuant to MCL 15.268H. I need a motion.
So moved. Support.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Hager, supported by Councilwoman Hall. Madam Clerk, roll call, please.
Councilman Knox, sorry.
Yes.
Councilman Wetisha.
Yes.
Councilman Shoemaker.
Yes.
Councilwoman McCartney.
Yes.
Councilwoman Hall.
Yes.
Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty.
Yes.
Mayor Taylor.
Yes.
7 positive votes. Motion carried, Mayor.
Thank you. We will go into closed door session after items for discussion by City Council, and then we will come back out and resume the last three items on our agenda here. Next item on the agenda is going to be appointments. We have none tonight. Is that correct, Mr. Monroe?
That is correct.
Okay, but we're always looking for volunteers, and we're always looking for...
I think I jinxed myself. We've got a couple openings now after I was patting ourselves on the back for being all fooled up a couple meetings ago.
So we're always looking for volunteers. So if you're willing to help the City of Roseville, we'd appreciate it. Moving on, next item on the agenda is our second hearing of the public. Hearing of the public is designated. Public comments on agenda items are only heard at the first hearing. Second hearing will be on any city business. Upon poaching the podium, please state your name and address and address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions, input information, or express opinions to the council. Anyone using inappropriate language, you call out of order, or correct your language, or leave the podium. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules, be called out of order by the chair. Anyone from the public wish to be heard on any city business at the second hearing of the public? If not, we're going to move into reports from administration departments, reports from our city clerk. Madam Clerk.
Thank you, Mayor. The election has been certified today. I would also like to thank my staff, Deputy City Clerk Jackie Crimboli, Mackenzie Tavernier, Jackie Grise, and all the election workers on a job well done this election. That's all I have, Mayor.
Questions for our clerk? I understand we were the first ones to have all of our votes in. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay. Keep up the good work. We appreciate it. Next item is reports from our city attorney, Mr. Thomas.
Yes, Mayor. I just have a quick update on the recreational marijuana appeals that have been filed. We're still in the process of accumulating all the data for the hearing officer, which will then be distributed to himself as well as myself, so that I may respond on behalf of the city to the various appeals that have been filed. It takes quite some time pulling these together. We do have, I believe, 9 appeals, and Mr. Sexton has been accumulating that for the hearing officer, so it reduced the cost of that appeal process. Other than that, I have nothing further to report. Happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Questions for Mr. Thomas? Thank you for that. Moving on, reports from our city manager, Mr. Monroe.
Yeah, I'll be brief tonight, Mr. Mayor. Just wanted to, fingers crossed, hopefully council will ratify the proposal tonight with the supervisors union. We did four. This is our fifth contract that we've done in 6 months. It's certainly been an interesting experience doing that many contracts that fast. I'd like to thank Mr. Tomlinson, Mr. Fantuzzi, Mr. Gabicki, and Mr. Sexton for all their help and for all the union boards. You know, I echo what Mr. DeBruin said. You know, not difficult to sit down and hash those things out, but our employees continue to be professional and dedicated to this community, and it shows in their willingness to make concessions, but the right concessions to keep things moving forward for the city of Roseville. So thank you. Thank you to them.
Thank you. Questions for our city manager, Mr. Monroe? If not, moving to items for discussion by department heads. Mr. Gromyk, you have something? Yes,
good evening. Good evening again. I wanted to thank you for your support of those sale of city properties. Glad to get those off the books here. Two things tonight of note. The CGI banner program, the showcase banner, as you may have noticed, the banners are going up. Almost all of them are up. I think we have one business that was missing, so that's being remade and will be shipped to us soon. But those are all over our parks and our city campus and our downtown district. It's a great way to beautify the city and support the local community, and we are grateful to the businesses that did participate. If there are businesses that were unable to participate or didn't get the invitation, they're welcome to call me at City Hall. I can get them in contact with CGI, the company that helped us with this. It is a three-year banner program, so there's plenty of time. A great way to promote your business and show some community pride. So second thing, the DDA is working on revising their TIF plan, their priorities and their projects in the downtown area. We are releasing a community survey here in the next day or two. It'll be in the form of a QR code, or there'll be paper copies available at the city clerk's office. Mr. Zelmansky has been kind enough to help us out with that. So looking for any input throughout the city, business owners, residents, help us spread the word. We will be at the tree lighting with both the hard copies and the QR code. I will be putting it on the city website as well. All information is anonymous. We have a consultant that is handling all the responses, so we don't see anything. The only thing we'll see, there is a question about if you want to volunteer or help out, as you mentioned earlier. We do ask for contact information. Otherwise, it would be kind of silly to ask that. So that's the only information we'll see. It won't be tied to any responses, and that's Rowe Professional Services that's helping us with that. So all responses are due December 18th, so we're happy to get that up and running in the new year and get some projects going in the downtown. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, another Big Bird run went very well. We are in just coming of a support role for Mr. Lipinski. He does a great job running that. He's been doing it since I was probably 10 years old, so he does a great job over there. Compost pickup ends, I just want to remind people, normally it ends the first Friday of the first full week in December. This year there was a snafu in the way the calendars were put online, and December 15th was listed as a date. I spoke with GFL. They agreed to honor December 15th as a date. So December 15th will be the last day for curbside compost pickup. excuse me. We do have five new employees at the DPS that are kind of still going through the motions. They're in their just started their third month of probation. They're in at different levels of learning, so that's working out really well, and we thank you guys for keeping us staffed so we can keep getting stuff done. There was one more thing that I came up here to tell you, and I have no idea what it was. So I'm here to answer any questions if you have any.
Questions for Mr. DeBruin? Thank you, sir.
It gets worse. It gets worse.
I think that covers all of our department heads. Next item is items for discussion by City Council. Councilman Knox.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just want to thank the citizens of Roseville for re-electing me to the position of councilman for the next 4 years. I appreciate your support over the years, and I look forward to serving for the next 4 years. I also want to thank all of the department heads who made reports tonight. we just got a great team, and we appreciate all the hard work you put in. And that's all I have.
Thank you. Councilman Wetischa.
Thank you, Mayor. First, I want to congratulate Colleen, Kathy, and Carmel. Great election. I know it was a tough campaign, but you guys turned out real well, so thank you. Also, Jennifer, congratulations to you and your staff. You guys did a great job, as always, of course. My condolences to the Comment family. Of course, we lost John Comment a week and a half or so ago. He was our superintendent for many, many years. Thoughts and prayers to him and his family. And a very happy Thanksgiving to everybody. And that's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Thank you. Kind of echo Councilman Wetischa in reverse order. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody out there in Roseville that hears this broadcast. Yes, it was a great loss. Mr. Comment, my vice principal back in high school in 1981. He was quite a person. He was very well known and respected in the school district as our superintendent. Sad to see him go. Prayers and condolences to the family. I also would like to congratulate the council members who got reelected, Carmel, Colleen, and Kathy. Congratulations. And also, Jennifer, I'm going to say, echo it too. You did a great job. I think you're always number one getting the results back, and you and your staff did a great job. Thank you. That's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Councilwoman McCartney.
Thank you, Mayor. Jen, great job on the election to you and your team, so please pass that along if they're not hearing me now. And Carmel, Kath, good job. Glad to be with you for another 4 years. Thank you to the citizens that put us back here. We'll continue to do a great job for you. It was a sad week for Roseville. If you lived here and went to school at Carl Ravlich, we had Mr. Franquist, who was a teacher, coach, athletic director. He passed away. Father of Ann Schaft, if you remember Gary Schaft, she was a teacher at school, so was Gary, and also a principal, had passed away. Very young teacher, Kevin Gabriel, a teacher at Steeland. His wife was a principal at the high school, passed away. Two kids. That's a hard one. He was a young man, and that was a hard one. And obviously to John Comment. His family works here at the city, in the city, teachers throughout our district. And he's 51 years with the city of Roseville, and that really hit our school district bad. So three losses this past couple weeks has been really tough. But I want you to all know that they're in my thoughts and prayers, and with that, I would like to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving, and please cherish the ones that are still here with us. And that's all I have.
Thank you. Councilwoman Haw.
Thank you, Mayor. Well, I'm going to ditto a lot of this. I want to thank the clerk's office for another great job. They always do a great job. A lot of hard work and dedicated employees help out that from the city here also on that day. So thank you, Jennifer. Good job. Also, I want to congratulate Carmel and Colleen and everybody else on the council for another 4 years and continue to be a great team up here. So I'm glad to be back for 4 years, and I want to thank all the residents of Roseville who kindly voted for me. Also, condolences to the Comet family. John Comet was truly loved by everybody in the city of Roseville. You know, either they had him as a teacher or when he a principal or when he became superintendent, had some kind of connection to him. One of our police officers is also works here, was his father. So deeply saddened that we lost him, and my thoughts and prayers to the family. I also want to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving and truly be thankful for what we all have, because how little, how much we have, we need to be thankful for it. That's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty.
Thank you, Mayor. I want to congratulate the newly re-elected council members to the board, Councilman Knox, Councilwoman McCartney, and Councilwoman Hall, for another 4 years, and thank the voters for seeing the need for good, responsible people to run our city. And thank you, Jennifer, for your great job of, as usual, for doing the election, and all your support staff, everyone that worked, it was great. And my sincerest condolences to the Komet family. John Komet was a wonderful man, and he didn't deserve to go the way he did. But my heart goes out to his entire family and Julie. And I want to wish everyone a very happy Thanksgiving. Please be thankful for everything that you have, especially our freedom. And that's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Well, I have a lot of the same things to say, but first I want to start out by congratulating our Roseville Panther football team. Lost to them darn D. LaSalle guys again. I don't know, man. Every year we got to get them out of here. But they had a great season, and they came up a little bit short in that big game. So, but congratulations to their coach and their players over there. They did a great job this year. The Big Bird Run, Mr. DeBruin, the DPW workers and RARE and all the volunteers, our police reserves, our police officers, another great job. 45th annual. I think, Tony, you might have been 10 when Tony started the first one. But it was the 45th Big Bird Run. Carmel had a very large amount of his friends there. They were all runners, too. How many did you have, Carmel?
We had 13 volunteers.
Like volunteers? You had a couple runners.
We only had one runner.
One runner. But we had people from all over the Tri-County area running. There was a lieutenant from the Detroit Police Department. I don't know if the police chief ran. He was there, right? The fire chief? No. Did he run from Detroit?
A retired fire chief.
Did he run?
No, he didn't run. He observed.
He observed, like a lot of us did. But it was a great day. The weather definitely held up. And like I said, I want to thank everybody that was able to volunteer. No one got hurt. Our fire department was blessed with the fact that they didn't have to worry about any major problems there, so that worked out good. I think the only problem we had is some fellow, his drone got stuck in a tree, and some guy tried to climb the tree to get it out of the tree and almost fell, but he didn't. We got him out of the tree before that happened. But it was a great day. The election, Jennifer, your team did a great job. As always, first city to have all the numbers and election votes in, and it's hard to do that every election, but you guys are doing it, so you have my thanks for all that, and I'm sure the city of Roseville is happy for all the great work you guys do too. I want to thank the citizens of Roseville for our bond proposal that was passed. It's a bond proposal. Like Mr. Monroe has said in the past, it's a renewal of a bond, and eventually it will lower our taxes. And I'm just glad that passed. That's gonna open up the door for a lot of things that this city needs. And this board's gonna sit down, and we're gonna put together some good ideas. I know Mr. Monroe's already got a little list going, and it's gonna be a good meeting, but we got some money to be able to do some things, so that's gonna be awesome. I wanna echo our condolences on Mr. Komet and the Komet family. Mr. Komet was my social studies teacher when I was at Roseville Bravelick, and he was a great man. That's all I can say. If you ever met the fella, you would know exactly what I'm talking about. He was a great man. He was a very honest man. He was a very sincere man, and he loved the city of Roseville. And quick story: one day, every once in a while, I win some stuff, So we were at a Roseville East Detroit football game, and it was a 50-50. He says, Bob, you win all the time. He says, what do you say? We go halves on the tickets. I said, okay. So we both chipped in $20. Well, lo and behold, they picked our number. He goes, you go get it. And I go, no, you go get it. And I go, what do you want me to do with the other half? He goes, I go, I want to donate it to the East Point, you know, East Detroit Boosters, because that's where the other half went. He goes, heck no. He goes, we're keeping that. And I'm going to tell you something, I never laughed so hard in my life, you know, because he lived in East Detroit, but his heart was in Roseville. And it was just a fun day, and it's a story I'll always remember. He was just such a great guy to be around, and he's going to be deeply missed by the city of Roseville and the schools. Don't forget the tree lighting ceremony, like Mr. Gromyka said, on December 7th. It should be another well-attended event. And then next week, I want to wish everybody, the city of Roseville, and all of our employees and everyone in the area a happy Thanksgiving. Happy and a safe Thanksgiving, for that matter. With that, we are going to go into closed door, and then we will come out to finish our agenda. We have three things on the agenda, and hopefully we won't be in there very long, but if folks are sticking around, we'll be out shortly. Thank you. It is now 7:43 p.m. on November 14th. We are back in open session after going into closed door session to discuss three items that I mentioned earlier. So we're going to continue on with our agenda here. And the first item on the agenda is going to be item H, which is discussion and or action regarding Blunt versus City of Roseville, ED Michigan case number 23-11459. Do we have a motion?
Yeah. Mr. Mayor, I move that we accept the recommendation of council as presented in our closed door session.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Knox, supported by Councilman Wetisha, to accept the recommendation from council, which was provided to us in our closed door session. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. Next item is item I, which is council consideration ratification of the proposed Supervisors Local 1917 AFSCME Union Agreement. Can I have a motion?
Mayor, I'll make a motion to approve as presented.
Support.
I have a motion by Councilman Wetisha, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty, to approve the proposed Supervisors Contract for Local 1917 as presented. All in favor?
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. Next item, discussion or action regarding legal proposal from the city attorney.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Haw, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Haggerty. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Anyone against? Motion carries. That was pretty quick. Mm-hmm. And we're going to move into the next item on the agenda, which is our favorite motion, which is adjournment.
So moved.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Hager, supported by Councilwoman Hall, to adjourn tonight's meeting. All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting's been adjourned. Thank you, everyone.